Hello, my friends, and welcome back. In today's video, we are moving along in the Socialites Quilt Along, block number 19, the utility block designed by Lisa Alexander. And this was created by the Fat Quarter Shop. You can find a link in my description below if you would like to join me in this quilt along and download the PDF that they have for all the blocks. There are 36 blocks in total. We are now past the halfway mark and on our way down the hill. This is awesome. All right, so as you can see, I have cut out all my pieces of fabric and I'll just go over them again. I'm doing the 6-inch block. You can do three different size blocks. You can do a 3-inch, 6-inch, or a 9-inch. I just figured I'd pick the middle one as the easiest. For the 6-inch block, I needed two background fabrics cut to 2 3/8-inch squares. So I have that labeled A. And then for B, I have 8 1.5 by 2.5-inch rectangles. I just thought, as this is a scrappy quilt, I'm using different scraps from my many different bins of scraps. For the printed fabrics, I just decided to go with grays. For C, I have cut out 2 3-inch squares. D, I have 1 2.5-inch square. E and F, I use the same, but you can be even scrappier than I am and do these all four different colors if you want. You do whatever you would like to do. For E, it's 4 1.5-inch squares, and for F, it is 16 1.5-inch squares. F is the only one you'll have to draw a line from corner to corner, as you can see here. Try that again. Is it better? I hope that's in focus. Corner to corner. So I've done that for all 16 of those. And let's move these out of the way and get started. The first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna take your 2 3/8-inch squares labeled A. I have them both on top of each other. I'm just gonna cut them all at once. You just need to make triangles. So corner to corner, which then you'll cut. Give you 4. This first unit is the center unit, and it's going to be a little bit harder than normal as it is going to be on point, as they say. The next thing you're going to do is pick your D fabric in your printed. I have my D right here, and I'm going to take this off, and I'm going to do this. And then you're taking your A background fabric, and this is how you're gonna sew it together. The easiest way that I find to do it, if you have an easier way, go right ahead and use it. I fold this in half and I just finger press where the marks are on the outside. So as you can see there and there, and then I'm gonna fold the triangles that I just cut in the center, finger press it, and then match them up with the middle square as best you can so it's centered. And then definitely take a pin and pin right at that intersection, just like that. And then you're gonna do the other side as well. And then sew a 1/4-inch seam. And iron open. Once you're done that, we will do the next step for this middle unit. Okay, I have sewn these two ends on that square, and I've also pressed open the seams, and now we're going to do the exact same thing on these two sides. I've finger pressed them, made a little indent in the middle on the square as well as the triangle, and just right sides together, and there Here we go. You're gonna pin it and then just sew quarter inch seam and press them open, and any excess material just trim it off. That's what I do. Just less bulk then. All right, when I'm done, I will show you what it looks like. So now I have, so far, the center unit, and it should look something like this. Now you are going to take your fabric labeled C and do the same thing you did with your background fabric. I have mine on top, stacked on top of each other. Cut it on a diagonal and get my four triangles just like that. Fold them in half, finger press them, and then do the exact same thing with the center one. You're gonna actually wanna put your triangles right here and pin them and sew quarter inch seam. This is a little tricky. I don't do blocks on point just because you need to be really good at it. I'm winging it. There we go. I'm gonna pin this and then sew them together. And I'm gonna do the same here. I wonder, can we pin them all at once? Or should it, I think maybe pin, do these, then I iron them open just so then these corners don't get bulky and they might go all wonky. And I have enough issues already with wonkiness. All right, I'm gonna sew this and I will be back. Here is our middle unit. Not that bad for a first time. And it should measure 4.5 inches by 4.5 inches. Just trim it up. Now, the next unit we're going to do is the famous flying geese. So you're gonna take one fabric B and two pieces of fabric F, and you've got your drawn line on the back of F. Take one of your fabric F and place it right here in this side, and you're gonna sew on the line you drew. And then once that's done, you're going to have a unit just like this. So you're gonna cut a quarter inch seam and you are gonna iron it open. Then the second piece of fabric you have, you are going to take and put at this end and sew on your line, and then you will get your flying geese. And don't forget to press open your seams, cut and press open your seams. You are going to need 8 of these units. So 8 flying geese. When you're done that, I will show you the next. Now that you have all 8 of your flying geese finished, the next step is to make the top and the bottom rows, and you'll need E, your last 4 pieces of printed fabric E, and 4 flying geese. And you are just gonna lay it out like this. You're gonna sew the middles together and you're gonna get a unit like this. And then you're gonna put the ends right sides together and then do the quarter inch seam and sew that together, and you are going to get a unit like that. And then once you're done making 2 of these, so you need 2 of these, 1 for the top, 1 for the bottom, you are then gonna make 2 of these units. Take 2 flying geese, right sides together, quarter inch seam along here, iron them open just like that, And then we will start putting the block together. All right, now that you have all your units sewn together, you're gonna take the middle unit and you are going to sew these two units on each end, so the left and the right side. Once that's done, iron it open, and then you will then sew your top and your bottom. Here I have sewn the two flying geese to the center unit, so that's done. Now I'm just going to do the same thing with the top and the bottom and line up your seams, pin them, and do a quarter inch seam and iron them open. I'll be back with the finished block. And there it is, everyone, the finished block. Block number 19, the Unity block, designed by Lisa Alexander in the Socialites Quilt Along, created by Fat Quarter Shop. Next week, we will be moving on to number 20, the Honor block, designed by Elisa Bonet. And here is the printout PDF, and you can get this down in the description below. I have a link to the Fat Quarter Shop so you can download it as well. And what you'll need is, for background fabric for the 6-inch block, 1 1.5 by 5.5 inch rectangle, 1 1.5 by 4.5 rectangle, 1 1.5 by 3.5 rectangle, and 1 1.5 by 2.5 rectangle. For the printed fabric, you're gonna want 1 2.5 inch square. That's for your center. The other ones, you're gonna need 1 1.5 inch by 6.5 inch rectangle, 1 1.5 by 5.5 inch rectangle, 1 1.5 by 4.5 rectangle, and 1 1.5 by 3.5 inch rectangle. This is also known as log cabin block. It should be a really good beginner friendly block. Please join me next week as we sew along to the Socialites Quilt Along, created by Fat Quarter Shop. Thank you all for joining me today. I do appreciate it. Everyone have a wonderful quilt day. Bye.